If your engine lacks power, you cannot accelerate past a certain speed. One of the problems is catalytic converter may get clogged. This one, it's not clogged. I'll show you in a moment. It's not the only thing, so it's not the only possible problem, but it can happen. And if it happens, is because you have a problem with your engine. Your engine doesn't burn completely the fuel or has an oil leak inside the engine, burns oil. So you must fix the problem first and then replace the catalytic converter. Now, to check for a catalytic converter, oftentimes it's going to get hotter outside the converter, but it's already hot in a normal car. So this is difficult to measure. The best way is really to open it, just unscrew it from there. Screws are going to be stuck. Remove it completely from the car and put a flashlight behind the honeycomb on the other side and look and see how it looks. This one, it's pretty clogged. This one has to be replaced. I'll show you another one. This one also is very, very clogged, has to be replaced. And in the worst scenario, it breaks. This honeycomb is made of ceramic. Sometimes it can happen if you drive your car in deep water, in a pool of water, like where there's kind of a flooding or something like this, because this element is extremely hot. If you put it in water, it's going to shrink very fast, and it's going to break in pieces. Then it's going even to rattle inside. Obviously, you need to replace it. So this can happen, but it's really important to fix the problem first. And also, before you buy a catalytic converter, make sure you remove it and you test it with a flashlight. Don't listen to garages saying, "Oh, it's a catalytic, give me $1,000 or $2,000 at the dealership and replace it." You absolutely need to test it first. If you see it's bad, then one of the things that I suggest, if you see it looks like this, if you want to try this, buy lacquer thinner from your hardware store and soak it in lacquer thinner actually. Acetone, it works much less good. Make sure you use strong chemical gloves. That's really bad on your skin, like lacquer thinner. Try to soak it and see if you can clean it, and then put it back on the car and see if the power problem is fixed. So then you need to replace with a good catalytic converter. If you clean it with acetone or lacquer thinner, and it's you can see through it normally, but it may not pass emissions, and it may even throw a check engine, because the lacquer thinner may remove the materials that actually work to remove the emissions. So lacquer thinner is just to unclog it, but it may damage the material that actually does the job of reducing emission, and you may get a check engine. The check engine is going to be from the second oxygen sensor. There is a front oxygen sensor in front of the catalytic converter, and there is a second one after the catalytic converter, and the second one is measure if the catalytic converter, it's cleaning emissions or not. So if you damage it with lacquer thinner, the second oxygen sensor will trigger a check engine light. The sensor are perfectly good. It's just that the converter no longer it's cleaning the emissions.